Hello everyone. In the last video, I have covered about the waste management in general. So moving towards the biomedical or the healthcare waste management. So the definitions are, so the biomedical waste, it is the waste which is generated in the diagnosis, treatment or immunization of the human beings or animals, in research or in production or testing of biological products. So this is the waste which is generated at the time of diagnosis, treatment or immunization, or in the research or in the production or testing of some biological products. It also includes the waste which is coming out of the medical treatment which are given at home. So these are the biomedical waste. Now the healthcare waste is defined as all the waste which is generated by the healthcare establishments, research facilities and laboratories. So these are the definitions for your healthcare waste and biomedical waste. So there's a saying which says, let the waste of the sick not contaminate the life of the healthy. So we need to do the proper waste management of all the biomedical waste. So there are these two types of the biomedical waste, which are non-hazardous and hazardous. So hazardous are 20% and non-hazardous ones are the 80%. So hazardous ones, they are infectious and other hazardous. So infectious, they are non-sharp, plastic disposed, then liquids. So these are all the infectious ones. So because of this, because of this type of waste, some infection, it can be caused from one person to other. The other ones are radioactive, broken glassware, pressed containers, some chemicals or incineration ash. Now the categories of the biomedical waste are, so there are these 10 categories. So the first category is human anatomical waste. So this human anatomical waste, it comes into the first category, that can be the human tissues, organs and the body parts. The second category is animal waste. Third is the microbiology and microtechnology waste. So these are the waste from the laboratory cultures, human and animal cell cultures. So these are from the research works. So the fourth category is the waste shop. So that can be needles, syringes, scalpels, blade, glass. So these all are the waste ones. So this is the fourth category. Now the fifth one is, if there are any discarded medicines, like the medicines which are expired. So in that case, these are the discarded medicines and the cytotoxic drugs. The sixth category is the soiled waste. So the items which are contaminated with the blood, with body fluids, which are like the cotton, dressings, then plaster cast, lines, beddings, everything, it comes in the soiled waste. The seventh one is the solid waste. So these waste, they are generated from the disposal items other than sharp, such as tubing, catheters, intravenous sets. So these all are the solid waste. Eighth category is the liquid waste, the waste which is generated from the laboratory and the washing, cleaning, housekeeping and the disinfecting activities. So in that, it is the eighth category, that is the liquid waste. The ninth one is the incineration ash. So the ash from the incineration of any biomedical waste. So now this incineration, it is a type of disposal of your biomedical waste. So after that, in this incineration, there is the ash which is produced. So that ash, it is the ninth category. The tenth one is the chemical waste. The chemicals which are used in the production of the biological chemicals used in the disinfection as insecticides, etc., they are the chemical waste. So like I have prepared this mnemonic, that was this HAM, was discarding the soil, solid and the liquid waste in the form of ash and through chemicals. So then now we can remember this well. So HAM, A, H is for human, A is for animal, M is for microbiology and technological waste. Was discarding, was is for waste shops. Discarding is the discarded medicines. Then soiled, solid and liquid, as it is for 6th, 7th and 8th. Soil, solid and liquid. In the form of ash. So the ones which are like in uppercase, so these are the main mnemonics that you have to remember, the main words. So ash is the ninth category, that is the incineration ash, and through chemicals. So the 10th category is the chemical waste. So these all are the categories of your biomedical waste. The steps in the management of the biomedical waste are, so the first step is you're going to survey the waste which is generated. The next step is you're going to segregate that waste. Depending upon the type, it is going to get managed or going to get disposed as. The next is the collection of that waste. So now you have segregated the waste. So now you're segregating the waste in that different color coding bags, and then you're going to keep it in your workplace. So after that, there is this collection of this waste. Then there is storage of the waste, but this storage, it should not be more than 48 hours. Then there is transportation of the waste. The waste which is stored, now it is getting transported to its site where it is going to get disposed. And then the last is the treatment of that waste. So now first is this segregation, the segregation of this solid biomedical waste. So there are this different color coding bags. Now you will see this in your colleges too. So whenever you are doing a treatment or whenever you are doing something, so depending upon that, you are going to like segregate or you are going to put that waste in that particular bag, in that particular color coded bags. So first, the color coded bags, so first they are divided into non-infected waste and infected waste. Infected waste, it can cause infection to other person. Non-infected, they are not going to cause it. So in non-infected, there are two types of containers, that is the green and the black. So in green, it is the container which is made up of plastic. So in that, you're going to put the vegetable, fruits, peels, packaging material, whatever the general waste is, you're going to put it in the green container. Then in the black one, you're going to put all the discarded medicine and the cytotoxic drug. So black is for your medicines. So in that, again, the medicines, they are not infected. The next one is the red one. In red, you're going to put all the infected dressings. So those are the cottons, the dressings, then the cast, POP cast, beddings and everything you're going to put in this red one. The yellow one is the anatomical waste. Anatomical waste is the placenta, pathological waste and the body part. So that is for the yellow one. The blue one is the infected plastic. So that can be of syringes, but there are no sharp. So you're going to remove that needle from the syringe. And the only the syringe part you're going to put in the blue one. Then the gloves and the plastic waste, whatever it is, so you're going to put it in the blue one. And the sharps, they are put in this white plastic container. And this is like non-punch, so this is puncture proof. Because these are sharp, so the container, it can get punctured if it is not like puncture proof. So this container, white container, it is the puncture proof container. So these are the segregation of your solid biomedical waste. So this are the symbols that you should keep on this like plastic bag, so that it is known that in this containers there are some biohazard waste which is going on. So these are the two symbols, that is the biohazard symbol and the cytotoxic hazard symbol. So these are the symbols that you will see on this. So over here, this is a cytotoxic drug. So over here, as you can see, this is a cytotoxic. So this is the symbol of it. So these all are the infectious, that is the biohazardous symbols. So over here, now you can see, these all are the biohazardous symbol over here on this containers. So these are the segregation of your solid biomedical waste, depending on the type it is going to get disposed as. So this one, there is this landfilling which is done for this. The treatment is landfilling. In the red one, for the red one, there is this deep burial, yellow deep burial. Blue one, they are recycled. And in this, they are sharpened. So these are the various like treatment modalities for this particular type of waste, which I'm going to explain now. The next is the collection. So now you have segregated it. So next is the collection. So the waste bag, it should be tightly closed or sealed when they are about three quarters full. So in this diagram, now you can see the bags to be filled with only 2/3 the capacity. So this is the collection point. Then the next is the storage. So you're going to store in a separate area, room or a building of a size which is appropriate to the quantity of the waste. And the next is the transportation. So in this, the waste, it should be transported by the means of wheel trolleys, containers or the carts that are not used for any other purposes. And they should be easy to load and unload. They should have no sharp edges that could damage the waste bag, and they should be easy to clean. So the vehicles, it should be cleaned and disinfected daily. Now your bags, it should be sealed and labeled from the source of generation, and whatever the things are written, so the label, it should have all these things which is written on it. So what category it is, what class it is, the description of the waste, what that bag it contains, the sender's name and address, then all everything about it. So the date of generation, the date, year, then the receiver's name, everything is written on that label. So like this, the label, it is attached to the bag. Now the last part is the treatment and the disposal technologies of the healthcare waste. So there are these various like options in which the healthcare waste can be disposed. So these are the different ways. Now depending on the categories. Now we have seen in particular bag we are discarding particular like waste. So now what are the treatment modalities for it are? So these are the two like type of the container for the disposal of the biomedical waste and the color coding for it. So these are the first ones. So this was the first schedule which was given and it was renewed. So there was this renovation in the 2011. So this is the second schedule which was given. So in yellow bag, we have seen, so it is a type of a plastic container. In that we are putting all the category 1, 2, 3 and 6 type of waste. So category 1 was your human, 2 is animal, 3 is the biological and the microbiology and the biotechnological waste, that is the research, then the culture and everything. So the treatment modality for it is incineration or the deep burial. Now the red one, so this is again a plastic bag. The waste categories are 3, 6, 7. So they are autoclaved, microwave, or they are treated by the chemical treatment. Then the blue or the white one. So they are the puncture proof. As we have seen, the white ones, they were having those sharps. So they are puncture proof. So in that, now the category 4 and 7. So 4 is the waste sharps and 7 is the solid waste. So they are treated by the autoclave, microwave, chemical treatment and destruction or the shredding of it. So whenever you are discarding the needle, so the needle, it should be shredded first and then they are like disposed. The black one, it is again a plastic bag. The categories are 5, 9 and 10. So they are disposed in a secured landfill. So these are like the color coding and the type of the container for the disposal of the biomedical waste. So in my next video, I'm going to cover about this treatment and the disposal option in depth one by one. Thank you so much.